Tesla is now asking shareholders to vote again on a $56 billion pay package for Elon Musk. And this comes months after a Delaware court denied what would be the biggest compensation plan in corporate America.
Hey guys, tomorrow it will be decided if Elon gets his $56 billion bonus from Tesla. Here on the Scripto channel, we talk about AI. And you may ask here, like, hey, why does it even matter? This $56 billion bonus for Elon, why does it matter for us, for AI people? I will tell you why. Because it is possible that tomorrow the future of AI will be decided. Based on what is discussed in the media, in the newspapers, in social media, and also in our Discord channel, I can see three big misunderstandings forming around this Elon $56 billion payout, his bonus. Here's a quick background. In 2018, Elon Musk and Tesla shareholders agreed that if Elon makes the company, the Tesla market capitalization, 10 times bigger, Elon would be granted additional shares of Tesla worth roughly $56 billion. So that was an agreement that they signed. At that time, just an idea of automotive company like growing 10 times bigger and having a market capitalization more than literally the rest of the automotive sector industry in America, that idea was unthinkable. So it was like a miracle. But Elon did it. He increased market capitalization by more than 10 times. And all this time he was working for free. He was literally working for free. His motivation, his incentive was his bonus. So when the company achieved that threshold, shareholders agreed to honor the contract, the agreement, and to give Elon Musk his share. However, there were a few minority shareholders who objected, and they went to court. And a judge said, judge made a decision that this entire thing is unfair, the bonus is unfair. And the judge basically canceled the agreement. And then the media largely supported this story. You can see articles after articles talking about how the CEOs, how this greedy CEOs, they just lost all the shame. And so this is fair. Elon should not get his bonus. But this entire concept is based on three misunderstandings. I believe that there are three huge misunderstandings, and I would like to explain them one by one. Here's a misunderstanding number one, that Elon Musk is a CEO. It so happens that as a Forbes columnist, a former Forbes columnist, I had the opportunities to observe and research CEOs from different industries and different countries. And here's what I have to tell you. This is a typical CEO. This person has joined a thriving company and in just 3 years has destroyed it. The market capitalization went down 62% just in 3 years. And eventually he sold this company at a liquidation price. He liquidated the company at the cost of patents, basically cost of IP. So this is a typical CEO. And you know what's the most interesting part? For all this, for all what he has done, he has received a bonus. A very nice $25 million bonus for destroying the company. And we all know the name of this company, actually. This company is Nokia, was Nokia. The Nokia that we all loved and the Nokia that it was so cool. This person has destroyed it and received $25 million for it. And no judge was opposing to it. There was no decision saying that, hey, this was unfair. No, he just got the money and walked away. His name, by the way, is Elop. Elop. So just one letter difference, but quite a difference indeed, right? And here's Musk. He has joined Tesla in February 2004, just 6 months after the Tesla startup was founded. So Elon was Tesla's major shareholder. As you may remember, that was a time when the whole idea of Tesla was so revolutionary, so non-standard, that it was extremely uncertain, the future of Tesla was extremely uncertain. It was not clear that if the company will survive, not clear at all. So this is where Musk put all his effort and talent and innovation, his mind into this company, and the company thrived eventually. The company has become what it is now, one of the largest and the most innovative companies in the world. And here are two persons. One is a typical corporate clerk who has mastered the skill of sitting on the endless board meetings and nodding his head and learning what other people want to hear from him and saying this. Basically mastered the skill of navigating the corporate currents and corporate wars. And that led him to the steering wheel. And once he got that steering wheel, he destroyed the company that we all loved, and he destroyed it in just 3 years. And what do we give? How do we react to this? Yes, we give him, this person, a very nice farewell bonus for destroying the company that we all loved. And here's a second person, an entrepreneur, a visionary, a person who has created something from nothing. He has converted his vision, his dreams, into a material object that nobody saw possible. He changed the world. He made the world an absolutely different place, a much better place. And how do we reward him? We take his money away, his compensation. We tell him, like, no, Elon, not good enough. Sorry, no bonus for you. Bye. So this entire story feels very much like the Fountainhead of Ayn Rand, a story of the Howard Roark, of an architect, of a genius who was converting his visions, his dreams into the buildings, into the mind-blowing buildings that were changing the world. Howard Roark, who was, by the way, opposed by all, attacked by all sorts of Peter Keatings, destroyers who hated the beauty of his creations. This is who this person is. This is not a CEO. This is a creator. This is a maker. Here's misunderstanding number two, that this is just about Tesla. Like, hey, we're just one company, why does it matter, right? Here's why. It turned out that Tesla is the only Western EV manufacturer, successful EV manufacturer. And guess who is the rest of the successful EV manufacturers? Yeah, that's right. They're all Chinese companies. I don't know if you heard, but China last year has become the world's largest importer of cars. And the main reason, the main component of this were actually EVs, electric vehicles. So Tesla is the only key that the Western world still has to this market, to the world automotive market, electric market, electric vehicles market. And a judge from Delaware decided to throw this key away. So the misunderstanding number three is that this is all about EVs, just EVs. So who cares? It's just one little industry. It doesn't matter, right? Well, here's why it matters. Because when you actually see an EV, electric vehicle like Tesla or BYD, you do not see a car. What you see is a data harvester. Data has become the most scarce commodity of our time, because data is the fuel that AI models need to train to become better. And it just so happens that the recent AI models like LLMs, like ChatGPT and others, they have already consumed almost entire available internet. And to become better than what they are now, they need even more data. And where is this data coming from? That's right, from these machines, from these electric vehicles. So these are not cars. These are data harvesters. So the AI supremacy will be in the hands of those who control electric vehicles. So do you see the link? Elon Musk means Tesla. Tesla means electric vehicles. And electric vehicles means data harvesters and AI supremacy. So, and that's the future. And the future will be decided tomorrow. The future of AI, the future of AI world will be decided tomorrow. And if you happen to be a Tesla shareholder and you will be voting tomorrow, remember about this link. Elon, Tesla, EVs, data harvesters, AI supremacy. So the future will be in your hands tomorrow. And if you are not a Tesla shareholder, you can still make the difference. Spread this message. Like this video, share it. Maybe your like will be the one that will move the needle. So make it spread like a forest fire. And do it now, because tomorrow will be too late.